Welcome back to Vegas Live with Nina. I'm Nina, your host. Of course, we're in Las Vegas. Absolutely wonderful. I have Dina Poulton with me, and don't actually know what she does, except I think it's a little bit of brush and paint and paint and brush and making the world a little prettier out there and more exciting. Am I right?
Yes, yeah, you're right.
I think I got it right.
I
see you've got a Father Christmas hair.
Yes, I have brought a few samples of what we're going to be painting on December 4th.
So what's happening December 4th? This sounds like a busy, nice day.
Yes. Brush It Up Mobile Paint Parties. We're going to be at Distill Flamingo on Durango, and we're going to be doing a paint and sip party. So they're going to get to choose one of these lovely paintings.
Look at this. This is very appropriate because of, you know, Christmas and all that stuff.
And this my happy snowman.
This is the snowman. Actually, this is what they can be celebrating back east right now, because apparently they're having 5 feet of snow. And I mean, Denver, I think, started the snowstorm, and nobody can get out and nobody can get in. And everybody's going to have Thanksgiving at the airport. How cool. I hope they've got plenty of turkeys there.
Right. And here's some ornament.
This is lovely.
Yeah.
Madison First Xmas.
Yeah, it's my daughter.
Oh, that's your daughter. So, your daughter didn't paint this, did she?
No.
I was going to say.
It's her first Christmas.
There we go. So you've got all this going.
She loves to watch.
For you. And what exactly is it that you're trying to put out there? You said mobile, so which means that you've got a truck, right?
Well, I fit it all in my car.
Whatever you have. And you drive to a place?
Yes.
And you actually do, what do you do it in the parking lot, or what happens?
We go to the house. Like, I did a bachelorette party last weekend, and so what I did is they booked me online.
Bachelorette party?
Yeah.
Bachelorette party doesn't sound anything like children, so let's...
They had children there.
They did?
I was surprised.
Wow.
It was more like a wedding shower.
Okay.
But they called it a bachelorette. Okay. So I went there. I set up on the tables, I brought my easels, paintbrushes, paint, and then we did a champagne bottle.
So
and
did you
I set
up
the design.
Do this yourself?
I did do this one myself.
Okay, so this is what she actually does. I always love artists because my mother was an artist. She painted as well, one of her hobbies. So you do this, you bring this there.
Mm-hmm. And I show them step by step how to do it. And let them get creative.
Now, is it done? Because I know there used to be a paint by numbers.
Well, I give them a blank canvas.
So they get a blank,
They get a blank canvas, and I tell them starts. I try to break it up. It's like first we do backgrounds, the main piece, and then the details.
Is whatever color they choose.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't actually have something you put on top of her and then kind of paint over it.
No.
You've never heard of that. That sounds like it's an English thing. I'm not quite sure what it is, but anyway.
Well, some of the kids all draw the design on for them and let them paint.
Oh, so you'll draw
sometimes.
The design. Yes.
Yeah.
So you you encourage them to draw their own design.
I do.
Mm-hmm. Because then that brings out their own, you know, whatever they have. They could be an artist in life.
Mm-hmm.
So what made you start this? I mean, what do you gain out of this, and how is this a business?
All right, so what I gain out of this is I love art. I've always been creative since I was young. And right now, I had a daughter back in March, and I nurse her, so she did not want to let me go back to work.
Okay.
So I had some free time, and she's very good, and she would sleep, so I got back into painting. And after a week of painting, I realized I was the happiest I've been in a long time.
How wonderful.
Yes.
And with your husband?
Yes.
Wonderful. Mm-hmm. What does he do?
He's
an artist.
PTA. He's a physical therapy assistant.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
So
he's pretty cool.
Yeah, he was very supportive of everything.
Okay.
So
that's one good thing, because you've got to get the spouse and whoever you're with, or whatever the case may be. The baby's too young, but the baby goes to sleep so you can do your work.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So he'd go to work, I would be at home, and then I started painting again. I loved it.
And you really liked it.
Yes.
So what gave you the thought? Because this is like entrepreneuring. You've become an entrepreneur. You've decided to get something together of your own. You're not working for anybody. You're working for you. And that must be something quite different for you.
Yes. And so I did get a lot of inspirations because I didn't make the model. So what happens, like about 2007, the paint and sip industry kind of started taking off, and there are different franchises that started to come out. And I always seen hire an art teacher. And I'm like, oh, that's kind of cool. I could do that, but never followed through because I had a job already.
Yeah.
And then, like, after I had her and I started painting, it really kind of sunk in.
Yeah, and I can really do this and I can do it well.
Yeah.
I mean, come on.
And I would have loved to get into a franchise, but then you know how to buy in can be so well,
what she's
expensive.
Talking about is any franchise is $250,000.
Yeah.
And up. Very rare do you find them. You can get in them for $20,000. That day is over. This doesn't happen anymore.
Yeah. And so I thought, why can't I do it?
I did it. This is the younger generation talking, so I love it.
Yeah, and I just was like, you know, I found a few different clubs that actually kind of cater to this. Like
really?
A paint party's
yeah,
headquarters.
You had to research that.
Yeah.
So how did you go to researching? Did you know what to research? Painting in someone's home? Or I don't know, how would you research it?
Actually, I just kind of stumbled upon it. It feels like a lot of times when something's meant to be, it's going to be. All of a sudden, I just started, like, kind of just trusting God and my heart, and it's just kind of...
And just let it roll.
Yeah.
But take the advantage of it popping up.
Yes, and it just...
Knowing when it pops up.
Yes, and it just... I started finding things. I'm like, I could do this. Yeah. It was, like, started off with a small idea. Maybe I just want to do some children's birthday parties.
Yes.
And then it just kind of... The more I started looking into it, and then... I just started finding all the information, just
so
a little bit.
So are you finding out there that there's a lot more people wanting to do art than you ever realized?
Yes.
Either learning it, because this seems to me like a learning. You're helping them learn to become an artist or become whatever the little fantasy they have.
Yeah, that kind of what it is. It's kind of like a little kind of fantasy, like a break from the real world.
Yes, because... You can have a job, you can go out there, but maybe the weekends you just want to get away from something.
Yes.
And maybe you want to test your talents, and maybe, you know, we all want to test to see how talented we are. So maybe this is something that they can test their talents on the weekend. If they don't like it, you can screw it back up and throw it in the garbage can. Oh, no, I never did that. That wasn't me.
Yes. Kind of like that. Yeah. And most people are so happy with their results. Like, I mean, I've had women, it's not about just the painting. Like, a woman came to me, she's like, thank you, gave me this big hug. And she's like, thank you, you just gave me what I needed. So it's not even about the painting, it's about just being the togetherness.
Bring something that you've done yourself. I think it's something that I didn't know I could do this, and I'm more talented than I thought I was.
Yeah, it's like they get confidence, like with every stroke of
the
brush.
That's the word, confidence.
They build a new layer of self-esteem,
no
and it just kind of grows.
With the layer, because painting is layers. So you've actually got into something that you thoroughly enjoy.
I do.
You bring to other people. Now, the crucial question is, the bottom line, how do you make money on it? So do people hire you for the afternoon or evening or whatever?
Yes. So I'm hired in for private parties. They put a deposit down and they pay per person. And then when I do the public events, like at the Distill Brewery, like on December 4th,
yes.
So they go to my website, they buy the ticket, and they show up,
and
then they meet new
people.
How
much would the ticket be roughly?
They start $35.
$35 and up?
Yes.
So what do you get for $35?
You get a canvas that size.
This size?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to bring the daughter's one up because... I'm just going to do that.
I know. I just love how the glitter looks in these lights.
Yeah, it looks like it kind of matches. Right?
I was like, wow, it looks amazing
here. It's
all got
red on and all that stuff. So they pay $35 and up, and they get something like this, and you provide them with the board and all the paint and everything else. And then what do they do? They tell you what they want to paint, and then you get the colors, or you ask them what they...
I kind of set up like a little mini portable studio. Like I take a part of the table and I bring all my paints. I lay them out. I have paint pens. And some of them I have stencils they can use if they're not feeling too brave.
Sounds like me.
So I have stencils they can use. Yes. I have some directions for them to make them feel more comfortable. And then I have everything set out. And if it's something like Santa Claus that's like kind of red hat, you know, I'll have more of the reds.
Yeah.
That's
amazing. So you do different characters. You can do different events and different characters, but all the events and all the not characters, they're all connected to a plain board. That's how it starts.
Yep.
Not this one, but it all starts out with a plain board and then it ends up like that. But I think what you're doing is you're creating someone's enthusiasm for life.
Yeah.
because there's something that people don't, they don't want to go out and buy a whole big thing of paintings. They mm-hmm. don't want to buy, because I know what paintings are. My mother was an artist as well.
Oh,
so my
you
mother
know.
Was many, many things, yes. And she tried to make me paint, but I think I had two left hands or two right hands, but I certainly did not have the hands to do it. I mean, maybe I should try it again, but I think the stencil thing sounds pretty cool.
Yeah, I still use stencils sometimes, too.
Yeah, I won't use it all the time. But everybody for each their own. But at least I tried it, which was cool.
Yeah.
So you're giving these people the opportunities. You mentioned something about the 4th of what, March?
December 4th.
I'm way ahead. Too far ahead.
Actually, you know, I am December doing one March 4th, too.
Cool, well, we'll advertise that as well. Two of the price of one. But December 4th, what's happening?
So December 4th, we're going to do a painter's choice at Distill. And
Where's Distill? What is Distill?
It's,
I might know, but they don't.
It's a local restaurant bar.
Yes.
So we'll be on the restaurant side, and it's on Durango and Flamingo.
You can go to the bar side and get drunk before you paint.
Yeah, and we're going to have happy hour prices there, too,
well,
for our party.
Prices, that's not for the painting, for the drinks.
Yes. Yes.
Clarify that matter. I'm just joking around. So they can go there. Well, that's really nice. So they can go there. What time does it start?
7 p.m.
Oh, so it's a night thing.
Yes.
That's pretty cool because they've been to work and they've all had a rough day or whatever the case may be, and they can come and relax and test their talents.
Yes.
How wonderful. So you're looking forward to that?
I am. We have
what
fun
do you
every time.
What to it that's different, that's encouraging? I mean, how many people do you get roughly? 20, 30 people?
I do smaller parties, about 10.
About 10. That's cool, because there's only so many people you can get to, right?
Yes.
So you do about 10 people, so that that makes it worthwhile to bring everything out.
I can also do larger ones, but I like, in the restaurants, I like to kind of stick to the smaller ones.
Yes, just to keep, so they've got other customers and everything else.
Yes.
going on. So 7 o'clock at the distillery?
Yes.
7 o'clock at the distillery. Do you know what road that, what street that's on?
Durango.
Durango. Mm-hmm.
Durango and Flamingo.
Durango and Flamingo. Don't forget, and then how do they get to you on the website?
It's www.brushingitup.com.
Okay, www.brushingitup.com. That's really simple and easy because I remembered it, so it's pretty cool.
Yes.
That's fun. And
I try keeping it simple.
Yeah, keep it simple. You know, it's funny how a lot of people like to have these great big, long, extravagant, beautiful names, which I happen to have, but actually spelling my name out is very simple and very easy, but it's just trying to get it together is another story.
Uh-huh.
But I think keeping it simple, I have another one, Nina at ninaspeaks.com. That's simple.
Mm-hmm.
So when you keep things simple, and I think we're just reminding of people out there in business, then it's much easier, isn't it?
Yeah, and I was trying to keep the name of what I do in it, too, so people know.
So they all know what it is and what it is. They read it and they say, oh, I know what that is.
Yes. Mobile paint parties.
So one thing I need to ask you is, you said your husband is with you 100%.
Yes.
He is. Does he help you? Like, would he be helping you on December 4th?
No. Well, in a way, yes. He'll be home with the kids.
What about kids? How many kids do you have?
Two.
Oh, two. Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, how lovely. And how?
Yes.
Who's the other one?
Mark. He's nine.
Mark is nine.
Yes. He's my helper.
That's a long. Does he go with you? Or I guess sometimes he can't.
Sometimes he comes, sometimes he doesn't. It depends on the situation.
Yes, I have to say the bar, if you're in a bar, you can't go in there.
Yes.
That's because he's only 9 years old.
Mm-hmm.
You've been absolutely brilliant. Thank you so much.
Oh, yes,
isn't she
thank
amazing?
You.
So this is something else you can do in your life. Go out and start creating a picture, something you have in your mind that you really love. Maybe your two children or three children, six children, maybe nine children. I don't know how many children. Or even do a beautiful painting of your husband and present it to him for Christmas. How cool would that
they
be?
They make awesome gifts.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Well, that one's going to be for Madison.
There you go. Is it?
That one's for my daughter.
That's from your daughter to her father?
No, that's from me to her.
Oh, that's from you to her? Oh.
So she'll have it when she's older.
So when she's older, she'll say, Mommy did this when I was 9 months old?
Yes.
9 months old. Got it right. Anyway, thank you so much for coming.
Oh, thank you
on
so much.
Me. Amazing woman, building her own business with her children and really making it happen out there, making a living as well, because that's what we all have to do. Rather than sit at home doing nothing and moaning and groaning and all that stuff, she's created something that she could do with her baby. And good luck to you.
Thank
Wonderful.
You.
We'll see her on December 4th. We'll be right back. Take care.